finds it, centers it, Backlund, and a block there, and it came up and caught Tucker Poolman in the face, and he's going to need some assistance.
Oh, that didn't look good for Tucker Poolman. And you know what? He goes right down at the moment, and Backlund trying to elevate that puck over top of him. And oh, man. By Hellebuck, and Lucic digs it out. Eventually works its way over to Backlund. And as he tries to elevate this puck, just catches Poolman right in the face. And, you know, you go down and try and block those shots. You want to try and put your lower body if you can.
PK Subban the fake. Josi across. One-time drive was blocked painfully. Look out.
Yeah, hit Cole up really
Ian
high
Cole
here.
Injured.
Guys, the mouth guard's on the ice. You can see it, and the blood's coming out. And that puck just came out, up like a rocket. This is kind of the textbook way to do it. But when it's going that fast, 100 miles an hour like that, you can't react quick enough.
Seven back with it. Rolling puck, plays it across.
Oh,
Green
oh,
hammers
no,
it.
No, no, hurry up, get the trainer on the ice. Oh my goodness.
Josh Georges.
Oh man.
Struck flush by that puck.
Yeah, Graham Rheinben. Graham Rheinben was right on the shoe. They got to get the doctor out there. Dr. Mahler's coming now. Watch 26. He's in the center of your screen. Good diving play by Semin. He goes down a block. That's Mike Green, one of the most lethal shots in the league for defensemen. And you'll see him. He just goes down. He sacrifices his body. And you see the whiplash of the head. These guys can shoot the puck so hard, and guys are so fearless when it comes to blocking shots.
Those are dead on their feet.
Look out. That shot came up high on Hickey. First it hit him, it looked like, in the chest, and then look, it came right up under the visor. Got him. Let's take a look first at that shot that came up on Hickey.
A rolling puck comes right up on, hits him right in the helmet area.
There's a shot, got block. Oh, that hurt Girardi off a first shot. Oh my, he's down. Call for the trainer immediately, and both the Red Wings helping to get him out there. Oh, I hope Dan Girardi's going to be okay.
Well,
he had himself a nice night with a goal and an assist tonight.
Number five, watch him. He turns his head.
Oh.
Yeah, he might have gotten it on the right. He got it on the right side of his face for sure.
Oh,
and,
my.
But underneath the ear, and that's definitely concussion protocol.
Back to a point for Martin. There's the shot. It's blocked by LaPerriere.
LaPerriere got in the face again.
And this is the second time this season. Ian LaPerriere was caught early this year, lost 17th, and there'll be concern on that Flyer bench as it's happened once again.
This is terrible for LaPerriere.
As Paul Martin gets the puck on the blue line, and LaPerriere, who does a yeoman's work on the penalty kill, he goes to block it. Martin's shot goes back across the seam, and it hits LaPerriere just underneath the helmet.
Stall. Shot by Holden is blocked. Oh! It hit Calvert and he went down.
Boy, I think it got him up high, Sam. That puck just shot right off the stick of Holden and up high.
Oh, there's blood on the ice.
Yeah,
oh,
he got it, man. Up high. Again, this ice hasn't been great tonight, so very easily that puck could have ended up on edge as Holden was taking the shot. And good to see he's up on his own and making his way to the locker room.
For Jonathan Blum to Josi in a one-time roll. That got Eves up high in the head.
Oh, jeez.
The rookie let a one-timer go, and there's no way Patrick could get out of the way. In his first NHL game, here it is.
Well, it turned up on the blade. Oof. And up
right
it goes.
Above the right ear. Yeah, it was a knuckleball. Started rolling as he let it go, and here comes the youngster that let the shot go.
He just went over to him.
Yeah,
you'll see
right
to tell Patrick Eaves, hey, sorry about that. Nice gesture by Roman Josi to go over to Patrick on his way.
It's worked back to the point. Here's Pettersson with a shot. Calvin with a save. I think he got it off the helmet, and he is down. Here's Adler. Play continues with Calvin down in the offensive zone. Miller works it across. Here's a snapshot. They score. Adler taps it in while Calvin is down on the ice.
Yeah, and immediately Trainer jumps on the ice to go and attend to him. Never like to see that. But for the Canucks, they just stayed focused and continued to make the play. Calvert was down for an extended period of time. When he spun, when he went down to block, he spins around. And it did actually go off the shaft of his own stick and catch him in the face area, the side of the head. Always dangerous going down. He knew it. He tried to spin. And right there jams Pettersson at the last second.
Shot. Drop feed, Brown, wrist shot blocked. Oh, and the follow through, it's either the puck or the follow through that came up. And Chris Tanev is down immediately, clutching his face.
I think it came off his stick. The puck came right up and caught him. And you see Chris Tanev's being helped off the ice. Brings it across and it's off the heel of his stick. And right up, he turned his head.
Paquette in front, Maroon charging in. McDonough the drive, and it's blocked. Oh, it hits Strollman, and he goes down. And is being checked out by teammates and officials. And they are waving for the trainer to come on the ice as quickly as possible. Tom Mulligan from the Lightning bench is trotting out.
Yeah, that was a rocket ship shot, and it went straight to the forehead, I believe. The terrible situation is that as he gets a well-deserved big hand from the crowd. And look at Victor Hedman, his buddy, wants to know that he's okay as well. Here's the rocket ship shot, and it does get deflected. But look at the presence of mind there by Anton Strollman. He puts his head down. That was really smart of him.
And Bailey's drive, Brask makes a nice save. Stales, a high drive. Oh, that one hit Paille. And Paille goes down holding his head. Don Del Negro hops off the bench immediately to tend to Daniel Paille.
Well, we're going to look at it. There's the drive by Stales. I mean, that thing just got elevated in a hurry. You encourage your players to get in shooting lanes, something we talk about all the time. It's part of the formula for winning hockey. Timer by Stales coming off the wall, and you can see the blood on the ice and Paille making his way to the Bruins locker room.
Closing in, centering there. To an open, great defensive play was made by Kempney, preventing an open net tally.
I thought that got him right on the chin, too. He's smarting.
Brilliant work by number six a few moments ago.
Kempney, I'm not sure, is going to be able to come out for this faceoff. There's the shot, the right side of his face, and the referee is going to let the Capitals make a line change here. They often don't, but because of the injury, they're allowed to put in Orlov for Kempney.
Mitch Marner out of the corner, backhand shot that hits Detcher in the face. He's down and hurt. Blocked a shot earlier on a leg, and this one went right up and hit him in the face, and he'll need some attention right away. NHLer last season, he's absolutely fearless, and we've seen him head off the ice with injuries a couple of times tonight. Here's the backhander by Mitch Marner.
Oh, and it wasn't his stick, it was Gaunce who got in there. He's sort of in the midsection, it just rides right up, and oh boy, there's nothing he could do. Fortunately, it hit a bit of the visor there, might have taken some of that impact.
Well, let's hope he bounces back as he did earlier in the game when he took one in the leg.
On it is Krejci, banked it back, and a shot came up and hit Stamkos right in the face.
Absolutely no chance. It gets back to the blue line, and Boychuk, who brings it pretty good, is going to rip this off the boards, and St. Louis gets his stick out in front of it. He got up quickly, and that hit him right in the face, and it might have gone just underneath the visor. And he's going to be thankful he had it on. That may have saved him a little more damage. Good job as you look at Steven Stamkos with a full cage back on the bench. There is no way any one of these guys are going to want to miss this one.
9 feet. Doughty stole one-timer. Oh, Burrows. Oh, my goodness. Right in the face.
He's up.
And in distress.
And heading to the bench. Mike Bernstein's going to capture him as he heads right to the dressing room. Behind him, and it's rolling a little bit, and Alex Burrows takes it right in the chin down below the
vine. Away from O'Reilly, works his way in front. Big shot!
And an injured player. And it's Shattenkirk for the Avalanche.
He walked in and just fired. He shot the puck, and Chris Pronger's took it in the chest, and his heart stopped. Boom, right? Oh, my. Goodness.
Players were signaling towards the Avalanche bench.
Defensive blue line. Little drops it. Bogosian shoots. Blocked. Painful. Boy, that came right up on Motto.
I guess that hit him right in the face. We couldn't see from our angle exactly where, but that is as bad a sight as you're going to see. The blood is dripping down from Motto's face.
But certainly watch this. Watch where Mike Motto is. And this puck comes right up and hits him. Looks like just above the eye.
Well, that's the first thing when you get one from that close proximity to the shooter that you worry about is that the eye.
Oh, that one caught LaPerriere, and down he goes in a heap. He is cut. See the blood.
Again, Jonesy.
Yeah, he's down right in the middle of the screen there, and the slap shot, boy, did he blast that too. And Ian LaPerriere down, takes it square in the face and doing anything he can to make sure that that puck didn't get through to the net. And not sure if it caught him just under the nose or not, but I'll tell you what, it takes a lot of guts to lay in front of block shot.
Out, Trouba, Panarin, Strome in front. Oh, that hit Weber maybe in the face. Maybe he's got the mask, he's got the shield there, okay. Oh, that made him safe.
I don't know what it hit, but boy, oh boy. And how about this play by Shea Weber? Oh boy, right in the mouth. And he gets up, he goes over to the bench. He didn't want to talk to anybody, didn't want anybody helping him out. In fact, he was screaming at his players for giving up that defensive play.
Hands over to Elias. Elias a drive! And that
Sorry, Doc, that struck Philip Boucher right in the face. And having played, I seen that happen. And on the ice, there you see Marty Turco. He was the closest to it. Just cranks this. Oh, no! And Boucher is sure it's going to be low. He's got no stick. But see, in all fairness to Elias, a man is sliding towards him, and that's why he goes up. But I mean,
the same man who almost from the same place was hit by a shot that caused a concussion.
Now watch Matt Green in front. He kind of crosses his hands over and there it hits Mike Green. Washington looks to respond. Yarabek with a drive. Whoa, that hit Foligno up high in the face.
And the right referee's blowing the whistle immediately. And Foligno, you can see the blood coming out of his nose, caught him right under that face shield. Here's the tee up. Watch Yurbeck. Here comes the shot. And boom, as square as you can get into the face of Foligno. Here he is, the captain setting up. And there was no way to turn quick enough to prevent that Yurbeck.
Now Lindholm, got to pull it back. His shot hits Stetcher right in the face. Roy Stetcher. Got a puck in the face there as he went down to block a shot.
Monahan, the puck is up on edge right away. And right here as Lindholm tries to put it across, he fumbles it. And then right here trying to find Gaudreau back door, and it hits him right in the yap.